the Mohegan Sun, and you know, if you're a Met fan, you have to feel a little bit uncomfortable because you lost the specter of Steve Cohen. But if you're the Red Sox, you've got some kind of punishment on its way to being handed down. You have no idea what that punishment is. To this point, there's no official manager, although we're hearing today it's going to be Ron Roenicke. The Mookie Betts deal is not completed because they did not like the medicals on Gustar Graterol, and they want some other player from the Twins, and the Twins are saying no. So now the Dodgers and the Red Sox are trying to scramble to find another third team that will satisfy the Red Sox to give them that second player. But the thing that jumps out at me, Ron Roenicke? Ron Roenicke was the bench coach of Alex Cora in 2018. Now, the Astros didn't give the job to the bench coach under A.J. Hinch. He wasn't even a bench coach during 2017. They did not give it to him. Now, he remains on their staff. How could you give it to Roenicke if he was part of a staff that cheated?
But when you hear Dan Shaughnessy, who was on earlier this week, say the Red Sox expect to get very little in discipline for Major League Baseball because they don't believe they did anything wrong. If you really believe in your heart you didn't do anything wrong, then shouldn't you just keep it everything intact? Right? I mean, you had to fire Cora because that was the
why?
Tea leaves.
But if you think because, you didn't do anything wrong, why'd you fire Cora?
Because I think he was the focus of a controversy. It's bad PR. Houston let go of their guy. Because, listen, Houston hasn't really admitted anything either. But that just seemed to be what you had to do, fall in line, and the Mets eventually let Beltran go. It's a really bad face for PR. But if you believe that nothing happened, then why would you be afraid to just keep the same power structure intact? Letting everybody go or not giving a bench coach the opportunity kind of makes it seem like, yeah, we're trying to get away from the controversy because we were involved in it. I think they're doubling down on, we didn't do anything wrong, so why couldn't we keep Roenicke? He was on the bench during the 2018 championship. Didn't matter because we weren't doing anything wrong anyway. I don't believe that that's necessarily true, but I think they're just doubling down on the fact that they're innocent.
And the more this unfolds, I'm starting to believe that the Astros and the Red Sox and probably the Mets all had an under-the-table handshake agreement with Rob Manfred. Listen, we can only suspend these guys, but they really shouldn't be representing Major League Baseball. Why did Crane fire Hinch so quickly? Why did the Red Sox fire Cora so quickly? Why did the Mets fire Beltran when he didn't have anything to do with it other than orchestrate as a player, and none of the other players got punished? So I think that Major League Baseball and these teams probably had some kind of tacit agreement.
And listen, let's go a step further when it comes to the Mets, right? I mean, the Mets let Beltran go. Why? Because they probably got the message from Manfred. Listen, we can't discipline him. We can't suspend him because he was a part of the Players Association. Do us the favor, fire him, so at least there's some sort of a punishment. And, oh, by the way, when your deal falls through with Cohen, we got your back. All right,